Hello everybody, welcome back, ScratchRuffin here, and today we're doing a little bit more programming, and today we're going to add blocks and items. We're basically going to update them from 1.6 up to 1.7. So this is basically where we are currently standing at. We have our creative tab, but it is empty. And of course the name is wrong, so the name will be up after this video, so just, you know, stay tuned for that, and make sure you like this video, of course, and, you know, all of that crazy stuff. Yes, let's just jump into the updating. So, let's jump in here, and into our ScratchFun main modding class. Now, we still have all of our blocks here, but they are sadly commented out. Now, this will basically be blocks and items in the same tutorial, because, you know, there's not much to change. So let's do blocks, for example. We'll just comment out all of these, we'll take items later on. And this is basically all of our blocks. Now, these are not imported yet, because I removed the imports. Now, instead of hovering over all of these, you can easily Control-Shift-O. And it adds all of them. Now, if there is multiple of one class, it will basically ask you which of these is it you basically want. Now, I am currently in the net ScratchFun mod package, which is basically what I'm going to continue to say. Well, this is another mod and another class, so select a class you want to import from. And here as well, I have two macerators with the same class name. I only want to import the one at the top here. Block tomato as well. There we go. Now the teleporter as well, it seems like. Finish. There we go. So we've now imported everything, but we still have a lot of errors. And if we were to run this right now, the blocks wouldn't be registered. So set unlocalized name. Okay, it has changed, and now it's set block name. So set block name. That's very, very simple. Let's just copy it over. Now, on items, it's still the same. I'll go through that later on in this video. Set block name on all of these. There we go, and that should remove some of the problems. Now, set block name is undefined. Okay, so there's still a few things we need to do. So, we no longer have any errors on these top one here. So, let's see here. Set light value. Now, set the method is undefined for the type block. Okay, now we can actually just jump into the block class if we get up here and hit control on block. Now, this is basically how I figure out on stuff, basically, which I have no idea how to do. I'm just showing you basically how this works. So, light value is basically what we want, amount of light emitted. So, if we hit control F, and make sure to unselect this right here, and make sure it says all and not selected lights, and hit fine. Get light value, okay, and it said set light level, okay. So set light level is basically what we want. If we jump into our block here, you set light level, it will basically go from 0 to 1. So it basically the yeah, sorry. Only the method name has changed. Set light value has changed to set light level. So there you go. That was it for that method, I think. Now the set texture name has also changed. It's changed to set block texture name. Just added the block here, and that should do the trick there. Now block.sound grass footstep. All of these has changed. It says now sound and type. So if you just go down and hit sound type grass, it will basically be the sound there instead. Now here's all we have. Set texture name changed that to set texture block name. Very, very simple. Now set block name here is undefined for the type block slab void. Now that's because we have a error in the block slab void. Now I'm going to show you how to update the slabs in a different tutorial, or this will be quite long, but I'm going to show you how to update the block void, because a block void, which is basically the basic stuff, don't worry, I'll go throughout and update everything here, but the block void is currently having a few problems here. First of all, the super, this is basically the constructor in the block class. Now, it doesn't have an integer as argument anymore, so we need to remove this. This is basically the block ID, which is no longer used, which means that we can remove this ID right here as well, because it's not, you know, used. Now, satellite value, of course, is changed to satellite level. There we go. And sound ladder footstep is basically sound type, and then ladder. There we go. Beautiful. Now, images as well. Now, there's no green areas hard to see right now, but we'll go through that later. Now, if we jump down here, you can see that we have an error in the imports. Icon register does no longer exist. Now, no worries, it hasn't got removed, it's just renamed. So let's remove that import, and let's add a I, okay? There's an I in front here, and let's import I, icon register. Very simple. And let's save that. All nice and easy. Now, if you work with icons, it has now changed to iIcon, for those wondering. I'll of course do a tutorial on how to update everything, so I'll go through that as well. But this method does no longer have a green arrow, or an easy way to check it is just add an at override. It now gives us an error because it is not able to override this method from the block class. Which basically means that the register icons method with these arguments does no longer exist in the block class. Now it has changed just a little bit. So if we were to jump into the block and we do it Control F and, for example, register, we would quickly find that this method is now called register block icons instead. So basically add a block here. And then it should now have a green arrow, and if we write at override over here, it'll basically tell us, okay, there's no problem, you are basically overwriting this method from the block class. Now, it's no need to have the at override, the arrow here signifies for you. But of course, if you were to update the mod, it'll be nice to have at override over all of the methods that you are overriding. Now, not over all of the methods, because you're not overriding all of the methods, but those methods methods that you are overriding, you basically want a at override. So that's very, very simple. That basically means that you get an error if the method name has changed. Let's remove that because I have no need for that. I'm pro, you know. So if we jump in here, you can see that we now have an error. The 1000 argument is no longer used. And beautiful. So that's basically how to fix the block void. Now we still have errors on all of these. I'm going to go through those basically in separate small short tutorials. So what we're going to do for now is we're just going to comment out all of these, all of the blocks, and we're going to uncomment the items, and we'll go into register everything at the end here. So, item cobblestone nuggets. As you can see, we have all the errors here, just as we had in the beginning with the blocks. We need to import these classes, so Ctrl-Shift-O should import everything, and I have multiple of item basic. I want it from NetScratchFun mod. And there we go. So, it has successfully imported everything. Now, there is a few stuff that needs to be changed here. First of all, it no longer uses these IDs right here. But let's take that another time. So, first of all, here, it's something, it says basically it says block.tiledField. Now, it's now basically blocks. Because it's net.minecraft.init, the blocks method contains all of the blocks. Now, all basically some of them at least has changed the name as well. So if we were to jump in here, and for example say tiled, no grass, nope, field, nope, farmland. Okay, so it's basically been renamed to farmland, and that's basically it. Now, there's still some problems in the item seed food thingy here. It requires an integer, a float, a block, and a block. I'm going to go through how to update all of that stuff later on. But for now, let's just take on the first two items here. That's very simple. The first two items here is item cobblestone nugget and item stone nugget, which are basically basic items. Now, it still has the set unlock list name, which is good. Sets the unlock list name of this item to the string passes parameter prefixed by item dot. So it basically adds item dot in front of the unlock list name, so item dot cobblestone nugget. Now, item basic, let's jump in here because we do have a few errors, because it says super ID. Now, remove items to match the super, because right now it's no longer using the ID. Now if you have an empty super, just remove the super, it's no longer needed to get called basically. Now I have an error as well up in the imports, it's the icon register again, and as you remember, it doesn't say icon register, it says icon register. So there we go. Now we still doesn't have this green error, oh we actually do, sorry, it was overwritten by this other picture here, but we do have a green error, which means that this name is basically, this is the correct name for our method, which is quite good. Now, if we were to jump back here, it says we have an error here because we have this item and the constructor is empty, so let's remove those. And we should be good to go. If we save now, we should have no errors in this file. And we have a block, and we have a few cobblestone nuggets. Now, it sets the creative tab, which is good because we have a creative tab. Here as well, it sets the creative tab, so we are good to go. We can now register all of the blocks and register the items. So let's jump down here and register the block first, for example. Let's jump down under all of these. So center it a little bit. Game registry. Registry.registerBlock. It needs a block. And the block we're going to register is basically... Sorry, what's it called? It's called block void, so let's just copy that in. And the name is basically a reference name, so we're going to do the same as the block name. So let's just do void block, okay? As you can see, these two right here are similar. And block void is basically the block right here. So that's basically registering the block. Now, we will still have a few items, so don't leave just a few items. We'll still have a few problems, so don't leave just yet. Let's register the items. Let's comment out this. And let's comment out this as well. Game registry dot register and an item. And in here we basically want the item we want to register, cobblestone nugget, and the name is going to be the same as the unlock last name. I'd like to do it like this. I don't think it's needed, but I just like to do it like this. So we'll add these strings, these thingies around, and then we need to register the stone nugget as well. So let's grab stone nugget instead. There we go. So we have now registered the two items and we have registered the block. Now we will have a few problems, one problem at least, running this code, so let's try it out. Now, as far as I'm aware, we're not crashing, which is good. But let's go into single player, modding tutorials, and let's see here. Okay, no crash, that is very, very good. Let's jump over to our tab here. Kaboom! We just crashed. Now what is this crash all about? It says null pointer exception. Now where's this render item? Render item. Now that's probably because I've set the block to block tomato. Sorry about that. Let's just change it over to blocks dot... let's what to set it to? What to set it to? Huh? End portal, no thank you. Let's change it into... I'm not quite sure. Lit pumpkin. That could be cool. Oh my god. Mob spawner, mob egg, must have cobblestone, oak stairs, quartz, a skull. Let's just do a skull. There we go, it's probably going to be like skeleton or zombie skull or something like that, but let's just hit run client. The item or the block I had chosen was not actually initialized. My bad. So single player, modding tutorials, no errors or no crashes should be done right now. Let's go into our creative tab. Kaboom! We're crashing again. What's up now? Rendering the item. Does it say? It says null pointer exception. Okay, so it doesn't like the skull. Okay, let's just choose the ender chest, I guess. Hopefully it doesn't bug out on that one as well. I'm sorry guys, I'm really, really, really sorry. It's just a creative tab messing up here. Nothing else, I promise. There we go. So it's now is basically able to grab the ender chest. So if I were to click on this ender chest, it would show up with our creator tab right here. Now we do have a few problems because none of our items are showing in this creative tab, and I'm pretty sure that in the block void it says set the creative tab to the scratch tab. So there is a few stuff wrong. Now right away I can tell you that. What am I doing? There we go. Sorry. Right away, I can tell you that textures, at least if we're to spawn in the block, would as well not be that accurate. So there is, you know, a few stuff to kind of work around. Now, an easy way to fix this problem, at least with the texture, I'm not sure if it works the other way around, but by moving the block void into the pre-init method in here, basically. And we ensure that it gets a texture. So let's do this here as well for the register, and let's do the items as well. It basically gives them a texture to have it in the pre-init. I'm not sure how it works with the creative tab, but we will check out. There we go, and let's try to run this again. It might not stay in the creative tab. If it doesn't, we'll look at it. Doesn't know where the texture cobblestone nugget is from, doesn't know where the stone nugget is from, and it doesn't know where the block void is from. Now, I can tell you right now that the reason because of this is very, very simple. Let's just have a pause here. Sorry, so first of all, our texture, or our mod ID, is not called Scratch for Fun old, okay? Our mod ID is called Scratch for Fun, so we need to set block name and then jump in here with our mod ID, like so, and a plus sign here, and it should basically make sure that we get the right mod ID. And our mod ID is Scratch for Fun old, which is not that good. So it looks like we will have to change all of these folders. So let's just refactor here, rename. Okay. Yes, refactor, rename. Okay, we need to save it. And let's just Scratch Fun, change it to Scratch Fun old. It's not a identified thingy here, so we'll just do Scratch Fun old, because why not? Now that means that we need to change all of the others here as well, but we need to change the mod ID as well. So let's jump in here, Scratch Fun, let's add old to the Scratch Fun here, because our mod ID, basically. This is basically so that we do not have the same mod ID as another mod, because I have two mods now with the mod ID Scratch Fun, so we need to have one of them at old. Sorry for this, everybody. And there we go. And let's just change the mod ID to old, remove that one. Now there is no need for the thingy right here. I believe it'll automatically figure out where it lies. I think if not, we will have to add it, of course, but let's just hit run here and let's see, does it have a problem with the textures now? It doesn't look like it has. Beautiful. So single player modding tutorials. Let's move it over a little bit here, and if we jump over, we can now see that all of these three have textures, and they are in our creative tab. Now, how did that happen? A lot of stuff happened at once here, but by basically moving these to the pre-init method, it works with the creative tab, and by setting the items as well into the pre-init method, it works with the creative tab, and it works with textures as well. So make sure you have them in the pre-init. This has been a long tutorial. I didn't plan for this to be so long, but there you go. Now the names will be the next tutorial up later today, so stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. My name is Scratch Fun, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.